Hi friends, in this particular video I am giving you a brief idea about how to control the direction of rotation of stepper motor. Okay, so in the previous video I was already given in which way A255 is interfacing with the stepper motor device. Now whereas in this case let us see how to write a program to control the stepper motor. So here this video divided into two parts. First part is let us see steps for writing the program for controlling the stepper motor. Then the next part is I will show you in the laboratory setup in which way I am dumping the program into 8086 trainer kit and how I am controlling the direction of rotation of the stepper motor. So experimentation setup also I will show you. Okay, then at the end of the video we can understood that how to write the program for controlling the stepper motor and how to dump the same program into trainer kit and how to control the stepper motor also practically you may observe. Okay, try to watch the video. So let us see. See the problem. So our problem is write an assembly language program. To control the direction of rotation of stepper motor. So we should control the direction of rotation. Means we need to control both clockwise direction as well as anti-clockwise direction. Okay, with the help of program. Okay, let us see how to write the program. Right here we are considering a stepper motor having four windings. So in the previous video I explained the interfacing diagram. In that we have only two-phase winding of a stepper motor. Now in the practical laboratory setup we have four winding stepper motors are available. So now program related to hardware setup, for that I am taking four windings stepper motor. So how many windings are present? Four. So what are the windings? A, B, C and D. Like that we have four windings are present in the stepper motor. Next see here, actually in order to write any program we need minimum 8 bits. So divide. So in order to get these four windings into 8 bits, so we are dividing each winding into two parts. Here divide each winding into two parts to make 8 bits. Because for writing any program we need 8 bits, but here we have only 4 bits. To make it into 8 parts, what happens? A, I am dividing into two. B also like a two parts. C also like a two parts. And D also like a two parts. So then we get A B C D duplicately A B C D. Put together how many bits are present? 8 bits. But in stepper motor, we are not exciting all four windings at a time. We are exciting only one winding at a time. First, I am exciting A winding. Then, accordingly, motor will run. Later, after some delay, I am exciting B winding. Okay, in the delay, motor is in the rest state. Then, because of exciting B winding, again, my motor runs. Like that, A, then B, then C and D, we get one direction of rotation. For example, after A, I am exciting D winding. Then, D winding, then motor runs in reverse direction. D, then C, then B, then A, it will excite, then motor runs in other direction. Like that we may operate motor controlling either in the clockwise direction as well as in the anti-clockwise direction based on the order of excitation. Okay, let us see first. See here we are making like a 8 bits. Now coming to first part, now first I am exciting A winding, so the corresponding bit must be 1. Then B, C, D must be not exciting. That's why they are zeros. So here I am exciting A, means this side also I need to excite A. Then only I am exciting A winding, right? So A. So here also we are exciting A. B, C, D must be zeros. Then what is the equivalent hexa for this 8-bit number? 1000 means 8. Another 000 is also 8. So what is the total address now? 88H. So what is the total value now? 88H. So if you send 88 data, then automatically which winding is excited in the stepper motor? A winding is excited. Now, next for exciting B winding, but the value A should be 0, B should be 1, C and D are zeros. Similarly, here also A 0, B here also we are exciting. This side B exciting means in order to excite B, so overall B should be dividing into like a two parts. So here B is exciting, here also B is exciting. Then C and D are also inactive. So in this particular case, only we are exciting B winding. If excite B winding, again motor runs. Okay, so in between A with B excitation, we are providing some delay. In the delay, motor is in the off state, like that. So what is the equivalent hexa for this is 44H. Similarly, next part is I am exciting C winding. So the C bit, corresponding C winding bit is 1. Here also corresponding C winding bit is 1. Remaining all are zeros. Then what is the equivalent hexa for this? 22H. Next, later I am exciting D winding. So the D1 should be 1. Here also D should be 1. Remaining all are zeros. Then what is the equivalent hexa for this 8 bits? 11H. So like that, if you send 88, then A is exciting. If you send 44, B is exciting. If you send 22, C will exit. Like that, 11, D will exit. But instead of sending 88 then 44, simply we are taking 88 only. Later we are rotating this 88 into 1 bit right side. Okay, 1 bit right side. Right side means, let us see, these bits are rotating right side like this, right side. Right side. So then what happens if you rotate? So this one comes into, after rotating 88 into 1 bit right side, then one comes to B's place. Okay. B comes to C's place, like that this one comes to B position. Here also this one comes to B position. Okay, then we get 44. Then 44 also if you rotate 1 bit right side, then this one comes to C side. Similarly, this one comes to C side. Then again 22 rotating 1 bit right side, we get C, 1 becomes D side. Here also C1 becomes D side. Like that simply you take only one number as reference and rotate that number 1 bit in the right side. We get A, then B, then C, then D, we are exciting. If the order is ABCD, then our motor runs like a clockwise direction. Okay, so in order to make anti-clockwise direction, we go with the left side rotations. Here same 88 I'm taking, here also I'm exciting A winding. After A, in order to make anti-clockwise direction, I need to run D, I need to excite D. For that what happens, I'm rotating this 88 data into 1 bit left side. Left side means, see here, like this we are rotating, this is the left side direction, like this we are rotating. If it is left side, what happens? This one comes to D's place. Okay, this one comes to D's place. Okay, one comes to D's place. Right? Then, see here, one comes to D's place. Then, C, B becomes 0. This one comes to D's place because it is shifting to, rotating to left side. So, that's why this one comes to here. This one comes here. Then, 44 also rotating 1 bit left side. Then, this one D come then instead of D, now which is exciting, C will exit. Here also this one comes to this side, C will exit. Again 22 is rotating 1 bit left side, then C, instead of C, which is exciting, B will exit. Instead of C, here also B will exit, like that B will exit. So in order to rotate 88 into 1 bit left side, after A, D will exit, after D, C will exit, after C, B will exit, like that A, D, C, B excitation order should be A, then D, then C, then B, then motor runs in a anti-clockwise direction, like that clockwise and anti-clockwise direction. So we can achieve just by making the condition ROR we get clockwise, ROL we get anti-clockwise. Okay, this is the actual idea. So accordingly, let us see how to write the program. Now let us see program here. So first part is for every program, in order to select, because in order to perform this operation, I need how many bits? 8 bits. So I need at least one port. Maybe I can select port A or port B or port C. So which port, it is your choice. So first we should make all ports are ready to perform output operation. For that, let us see how to write move DX comma 0FFE6. So this is the address for control word register. So control word register address is 0FFE6 is the address. Now I'm loading DX register with value 0FFE6. So here why I'm writing 0 in the left side means, so whenever if a higher 4 bit value is more than 9, then left side you should write 0. Otherwise what happens, it will give you syntax error. Okay, then move AL comma 80. Here why I am writing 80? If you write 80, see now this information is to related to 8255 operation. So in 8255, in the last before videos I explained control word register of 8255, in that we have 8 bits D0 to D7. So D7 must be 1, then only our mode is IO mode. So, and the remaining bits we can select as zeros, then they act like an output. So, for performing ports into output port, except D7, remaining all bits of control word register must be zeros. Then, what is the equivalent value? 1 followed by 7 zeros. Then, what is the equivalent XR? 80H. So, if you write 80H, then all ports of 8255 are ready to perform output operation. Then, out DX comma AL. So, then this 80 data is now sent to control word register, because DX is now control word register. Why I'm writing out? Because 8086 is a one chip, 8255 is another chip. So in order to move data from one chip to other chip, we should write in and out instruction. Out means sending, in means receiving. So now for output operation, that's why it is out DX comma AL. Then what happens, my 80 data is now loaded to control word register. 0FFE6 is the address of control word register. Then control word register understood that processor wants to make all ports becomes output port. Like that, these three steps are essential for every output operation, for every control, like not only stepper motor. If you go for any waveform generation, like a sawtooth wave, triangular wave, square wave, or if you go for any traffic light control, or if you go for any peripheral control. So in all those applications, we need to make all ports are ready to perform output operation. Then these three steps are essential. Then coming to our problem. So now selection of ports are ready for output operation based on these three steps. Then what is next step? First, in the stepper motor, I need to select A winding. For selecting A winding, which but the equivalent value I need to send 88. For that I need one port. See here, first I am taking move AL comma 88H. In that my AL taking which value? 88. Why I am writing 88 to exit port A? For that 88. Then move DX comma 0FFE0. So here 0FFE0 is the address of port A. So in this program, for taking 8 bits, I am taking port A into account. So port A address is 0FFE0. So now my DX is equal to 0FFE0. Then I am writing out DX comma AL. So then my port A receiving which value? 88. Because of that 88, what happens now in that port automatically after receiving 88, then port A sending information to stepper motor, in that it will exit which winding? A winding. Okay, A winding excitation is over. Then motor runs. So you know, we need to provide some delay between excitation of one winding with other winding. For that I need to provide delay. See now this line for providing delay. See here, move CX comma 0FFFH. Nothing but maximum delay I'm calling. Then okay, then I'm writing next lines here, NOP. NOP means no operation. No operation means no motor comes into off state, stop, run state. Stop state. It won't run. So like that, I'm writing NOP, NOP. Nothing but no operation means between excitation of one winding with other winding, I'm providing this much delay. Then loop L2. You know, what is the meaning of loop L2? Loop L2 instruction will decrement the value of CX by 1 and checking whether CX is 0, 0 or not. So after making a no operation, then CX is decrementing by 1. After decrementing by 1, what is the value? 0FFFE now. Is it 0, 0? No, 0FFE is not 0. Then again it will go. Again, no operation will execute. Like that, this loop repeats for how many times? 2 power, see here, 0, 4FF, 4Fs. So this many times, your motor is in the V-state, off state. Then, okay, whenever CX comes to all zeros, then loop fail. It will comes to next line. In that, I am writing ROR for clockwise rotation, ROL for anti-clockwise. Don't write these two at a time. Write ROR first, observe the motor controlling and all. Okay, then remodify the program with ROL. Then we can observe the other direction of rotation. Okay, so ROR or ROL, only one instruction you should write. Then AL comma 1. What is already AL? AL is already equal to 88. Now this 88 is rotating either right side or left side by 1 bit. 1 bit. Then see here. If it is writing, rotating right side by 1 bit, then after A, which winding is exciting? B. Then later C, then D. If it is left side, after A, then D, then C, then B will exit according to the same order. Okay. For that, we are writing ROR or ROL AL comma 1. 1 bit it is rotating. So if you execute ROR AL comma 1, then after rotating 88 into 1 bit right side, what is AL value now? 88 becomes 44. 88 into 44. Okay, like that we get. Here also I was not modified. I think it is 11. So this is 22 only and this is 44. So for right side, okay, if you rotate 1 bit, then we get 44 here. Okay, if it is left side, we get 11. Left side rotation, we get 11 here. Okay, right, like that. ROR and ROL. Then jump L1. Then it will go, jump is unconditional. So we are not specifying how many times it will jump. Jump means unconditional. So as on, if power is available, motor will run continuously until we can make a reset. Okay, until reset, it is continuously, motor is rotating in the specified direction. Jump L1, then it will go L1 here. Then out DX comma AL. So then my AL is, what is value here after rotating? AL should be either 44 for ROR, for 11 if it is ROL. Then my port here receiving 44 value for ROR, for example. Then with that 44, what happens? B winding will exit, motor will run. After running, what happens? We are providing again same delay. Okay, during this delay, between B and C excitation, motor stops. Okay, then next, again we are rotating 44 with 1 bit right side. Then we get AL into 22. Nothing but we are exciting now, C, ready for exciting C winding. Then jump L1. Again, it will go here. Okay, then my DX is nothing but port A. Port A now taking which value? 22. Then it will exit C winding. After exiting C winding, again will provide this much delay. Like that, it is continuous. A, B, C, D. Again, A, B, C, D, A, B, C, D. Like that, it will continue infinite time. Okay, until power fail. Okay, so it will continue continuously. It will, motor is running. So, okay, if you press reset, then only it will stop. Okay, like that, A after B, C, D, then A, B, C, D for ROR. For ROL, A, then D, then C, then B will continue. Okay, like that we can write the program. Okay, now next, later we'll see how to dump same program into trainer kit, and let us see how trainer kit is connected to stepper motor. Okay, then how we are controlling clockwise and anti-clockwise, we'll see. Okay,
now let us see the stepper motor interfacing circuit. Okay, here This is actually 8086 trainer kit. So internally we have 8255 memories. Okay, all are present in this 8086 trainer kit. Okay, now this is a stepper motor interfacing circuit, and this is our stepper motor. Actually, the stepper motor having four windings. So we have ABCD windings are there. So each winding having two ends. For that, we are using 8-bit information here. Okay, now stepper motor also requires supply. That's why I am connecting one adapter here. Okay, so for this trainer kit also we need a 5 volt supply. That's why I am using one more RPS here. Okay, this is patch card. With help of patch card, I am sending the program from trainer kit to stepper motor interfacing device. Accordingly, motor will run. Okay, these are the components. And here, with help of keyboard, we can type our program into trainer kit. Let us see program. So now I am typing my program in A space 2000 location. So here, instruction is move DX, 0, FF, E6. Then move AL, 80, then out DX, AL, then move AL, 88, move DX, 0, FF, E0, this is port A address, then out DX, AL, we are sending 88 data to port A now. Then in order to provide delay, I am providing move CX, 0, 3, FF, okay, I am taking this much delay. If you want, we can change the delay value also here. Then exchange, nothing but no operation, exchanging AX with AX means no operation, like that NOP. Then later, that loop is continuing, loop 2000F. I'm writing. So then for ROR indicates it's a clockwise rotation. For that ROR AL, 1, then jump 2000, nothing but in order to make same program infinity number of cycles. For that I'm writing unconditional jump. This is the program. Let us see how to run. So for running we need G equal to 2000, where we are writing program in 2000, that's why G equal to 2000. But before giving run command, we should check once whether we are giving power supply to our stepper motor or not. So now G equal to 2000, okay, then I am pressing enter. If you observe here, see here, now stepper motor is rotating in the clockwise direction because I am indicating condition is ROR, due to that it is rotating in the clockwise direction. Like that we can control the motor in the clockwise direction. In order to get anti-clockwise direction, simply I will change the condition here. Here I am making reset. Now let us see A space 2000. So wherever ROR is there, just modifying it into ROL now. ROL, same AL, 1. Okay, the remaining part of the program is same. Then again I am running G equal to 2000. If you observe the direction of rotation, now stepper motor is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction. Like that, with help of 8086 trainer kit, we can easily control the direction of rotation of the stepper motor through experimentation also.
Thank you for watching this video. Okay, if you really like it, please kindly share my video to your friends. Okay, subscribe my channel. Thank you.